I just saw today that these Bluetooth headphones from Philips, over-the-ear headphones for around $80 was released today, and there's not a single review of them on YouTube yet. So I was in need for a couple of new Bluetooth headphones because my old Sonys were wearing out, and you know, I thought, when I saw that there wasn't a single review of these yet, I thought, let me be the first to review them. So we're going back to my crib right now, where we're gonna unbox them and then we're gonna test them, guys. See you back at the crib. What's up, guys? So we are back at the crib here with the headphones that we're gonna test today, and I've been looking forward to getting some new Bluetooth headphones. I was thinking about buying the Sony 710, but I read a couple of bad reviews about people having problems with the earphones being too close to the ear, and I tried them on the store and I kind of felt the same thing, you know, they were hitting my ear. So they're probably not going to be comfortable for long time use, and I really used them a long time. So I saw this release today, and I thought, let me be the first to review them because there was no YouTube reviews up yet. So let's be first for once, guys, and help me support this channel. Like this video, subscribe to my channel so we can keep bringing you brand new 0-day content. So these guys here are probably the cheapest over-the-ear Bluetooth headphones from a quality brand on the market. So they last 29 hours of playtime, and it takes only 2 hours to fully charge them. So they're probably some of the quickest charging headphones on the market, and they have this button, a special button to increase the bass. You know, you only have to click one button and the bass will increase. So that sounds pretty interesting so far. And they can also fold, as you can see here. So let's unbox them, guys, and test them out. So that's how they come. A little bit cheapish, I would say. You know, this is just one of these. I don't know if it's plastic or whatever this thing is. They just come like this. And you know, there's some manuals in here, and this fell out of the box. In here we have a USB-C. They're USB-C powered, so we have a USB-C charging cable. And they were even nice enough to include a 3.5 to 3.5 male headphone jack, because these headphones use a 3.5 headphone jack on them. So that's basically the box, nothing else here. A little bit disappointing. Maybe we should have had a carrying case or whatever. So what is the feel of them? That's pretty strange. So when I turn them like this, both of them turn to the exact same diameter, they turn exactly the same degrees here. But when I turn them the other way, one of them only turns, this one, it doesn't turn anymore, and this one keeps turning. So, but the feel, I would say it feels okay. It feels not amazing quality, you know, but for $80, it feels pretty good quality. The plastic is good. It's a good feel. So the cushion here is the exact same height as the plastic here around it. I don't know how it's gonna feel, but it seems a little bit not well thought through. So I don't know, guys. So should we test them? I've already paired them with the computer. So let's test them. From time to time, I'm clicking on the bass button. So, you know, they have this button you can click on to increase the bass level. And that's why I'm pressing from time to time. I'm hitting the bass button to see how it sounds with the bigger bass and with the lower bass. And also, it's kind of strange with these over-the-ear headphones. Your voice sounds different. So that's not the most optimal thing when I'm doing live streaming, that, you know, for me now, I used to use over-the-ear headphones. Now, when I used to use on-ear headphones, now when I'm using over-the-ear, my sound sounds different to me, and, you know, it's kind of annoying. But let's keep going. That was very interesting. So there was with the bass and without the bass. With the bass, without the bass, they're actually a little bit shallow sounding, but very clear. So I imagine that would be very good for listening to podcasts and things with a lot of voice where people speak, watch YouTube videos of reviews and things like that. But when I hit the bass button, these pieces where the bass kicks in, the bass is on point. It really sounds on point. It's not too much. The headphones doesn't rumble. It's like the tone, it changes a little bit. And, you know, the bass becomes on point. The highs become a little bit muffled. You know, you cannot hear it with music where there is bass. Then it sounds great. But if there isn't bass and you compare it with and without, if there's no bass at all, then it sounds better without the bass on here, without hitting the bass button. But if there is bass on in the music, then it sounds better with the, you know, as a whole, even the highs, they sound better when you hit the bass button, if that makes any sense. So I think they sound great for the price, and you know, when you hit the bass button, it's really good. It does not distort at all, no clipping, you know, even though I've turned them up to max level, which isn't that high, but still, you know, they don't go in crazy high, I think, but still, the bass is on point. It sounds really great, really, you know, not too big, but I just like the sound of it. It really sounds great, the bass, I think. So, but what about the comfort? So, they are light, you know, not too light. They are a little bit lighter than the Sony 710s. These are 210 grams, and the 710s, I think they are 220-230 grams, so they're a little bit lighter, but I don't feel the ear pressing against here, so that part is better than the Sony's, I guess. But comfort level, they kind of press a little bit, maybe because they're brand new, maybe they will get a little bit looser. They press a little bit against my head. It's not uncomfortable in any way, but it could become, you know, if I use them for prolonged use, which I will. So I will probably make another review after I've been using them for a couple of weeks. And, you know, then we can do a follow-up review. But else, they are, you know, comfortable. The ears fit good. They fit good. But they're probably going to take a little bit of getting used to. You know, I remember with my old headphones, you know, these Sony. Yeah, just some cheap ones. When I started using them, you know, it hurt a lot. You know, when I used them for a couple of hours, it hurts a lot in my ears afterwards. It hurt maybe for days. But when you get used to them, then it stops hurting because your ears, they form after the speakers or whatever, or the speakers form after the ears, I don't know. But I have a feeling that it's going to be the same with these. In the start, it's going to hurt a little bit after prolonged use. But then my ears or the speakers are going to get used to me or my ears to the speakers. I don't know. So that's the feeling. But I will get back to it a little bit later. But else, for the price, I would so far, I would recommend them. I think they are good for the price. So that's all. Thank you guys for watching. Remember, like this video if you liked, you know, this review, and subscribe to my channel for more reviews. And so I'll be able, the more subscribers, the more likes I get, the more reviews I will be motivated and be able to make for you guys. So subscribe to the channel. Thank you guys. See you.